Good morning, students. Welcome back to English online classes. Today is the day 12 session, children. In the page number you have 17, you have some grammar part, children. That is about the tenses. Yes, learn about the past and the past perfect. I hope so you all have learned in your previous class, that is this class 7, about the tenses. Your teachers might have taught you about the tenses. Just I'll tell you very briefly. I'll be explaining only about the past tense today. Simple past, past and past perfect, because you have the exercise under past and past perfect. You all about tense. Tense means time. An action that takes place at a particular time is called tense. And we have in English we have three tenses, that is the present, past and future. And again these tenses have been subdivided into four. That is under present we have simple present, present continuous, present perfect and present perfect continuous. Under past we have simple past, past continuous, past perfect and past perfect continuous. And under future we have simple future, future continuous tense, future perfect and future perfect continuous tense. But today I want to teach you only about the past tense, children, because you have exercise under the past and past perfect. You must be a little bit aware of past and past perfect. But anyway, I am teaching you past continuous also. First of all, you must know what is simple past. Simple past means it is used to indicate an action complete in the past. It is used to indicate an action that has completed in the past. You all know about the structure of the children. Subject plus V2 plus object. Subject plus V2 plus object. An example I can give you. I went to school yesterday. I woke up yesterday. I did my work. Now I went home yesterday. All this you can use as because subject V2 plus. V2 means you all know. V1 means present tense. V2 means past tense. V3 is past participle. V4 is the present participle. So V2 means past. So it is used to indicate an action complete the past. An action that have been already completed in the past is called the simple past. And what is past continuous tense? The past continuous tense is used to denote an action going on at some time in the past. And the past continuous is used to denote an action going on at some time in the past. The time of an action may or may not be indicated. Sometimes it may be indicated, sometimes it not be indicated, children. So the past continuous tense is used to denote an action going on at some time in the past. It is going on at some time in the past. So the structure for that is subject plus was verb plus V4 plus object. Subject plus was verb plus V4 plus object. We can give some example. I was playing in the garden. We were playing in the garden. Because V4 means present part, that is in form. V1 plus ing is called V4 form. And next is the past perfect. What is past perfect? The past perfect describes an action completed before a certain moment in the past. The past perfect describes an action completed before a certain moment in the past. Just for that structure, I will say, children, subject plus had plus V3 plus object. Subject plus had plus V3 plus object. The example is, I had done my work. Another example is, I had seen him last 5 years before. You all know about the past. Past means the action has already been completed. But past perfect means describes an action completed before a certain moment in the past. The past has been completed. Before that past has been completed, this past perfect will occur. This past perfect will come before the past. You all know about the past, but this past perfect will come before the past. So, that is only given here, children. The page number 17 is given, children. I'll read out one sentence, you'll understand. The veneer had lifted almost everywhere. Both fire and water had taken their toll on this desk. See here, fire and water had damaged the desk before the author found it and bought it. Here, he has bought that rolled out desk to his home, no? That is, he bought it means already that that action has been completed. But the fire has been happened before or not? Before he bought the roll top to his home, the fire has damaged the roll top. Now tell me which one has occurred first? Past perfect has occurred first. Then only the past. So before the past, which has occurred? The past perfect. See, that is why it is given here, children. The veneer had lifted almost everywhere. Both fire and water had taken their toll on this desk. So before the author bought the roll top desk, the roll top desk had already been damaged by the fire. So here he has given, say, we use verbs formed like had damaged for an event in the earlier past. If there are two earlier past are given, we use had form for the event that occurred first in the past. When two sentences are given, it's a past form. That in before the past perfect will occur. Before the past perfect will occur. So, when I reached the station, the train left. When I reached the station, the train had left. See, you'll know the difference between these two children. When I reached the station, the train left. Here, when I reached the station, the train had left. See here, when I reached the station, the train had left. I reached the station. Reached means past tense. When I reached the station is nothing but the past tense. The train had left is the past perfect. You tell me which has occurred first. When I reached the station, the train had left. So which one occurred first? Past perfect had occurred first. So before I reached the station, what happened? The train had left. So before he stepped into the station, what happened? The train had already left. So we can say that the past perfect tense had already happened first than the past tense. So I hope you all have understood this, children. Because of this, I have taught you today about the simple past, past tense, past perfect. Once again, you just see this simple past, children. It is used to indicate an action completed in the past. So the action that has already completed the past. See, for this you can say, when I reach the station, when I reach the station. Reach means past. Reaching. So what is reach? Reach is nothing but the past tense, V2. So when I reach the station means already I have reached the station. That is past. The train had left. The train had left means where you find the had here? The past perfect. The past perfect describes an action completed before a certain moment in the past. What is the past here? When I reach the station is the past. Before that, what has occurred? The train had left. The train had left has already occurred before the past tense. So, before the past tense, what has occurred? Past perfect. What is the past perfect here? The train had left. So, the train had left has already occurred. That is, the past perfect has already occurred before the past. That is only we are telling here. The past perfect describes an action completed. The train had left has already been completed. Before a certain amount, certain movement in the past. Certain movement in the past. Before the past, it occurs. So, that is why I had done my work. I had seen him last 5 years before. So, just try to do this exercise, children. Because I have explained you very well about simple past, past tense, past perfect. Another one is also there. That's a past perfect continuous. Subject plus had plus being plus V4 plus object is the structure for the children. But we don't need this in this exercise because we just discussed with only the simple past and the past perfect, children. So, once again, earlier you have learned about that simple past and past perfect. See the definition properly, understand properly, and try to do this exercise by your own. Yes, learn some fill the blanks here. Just write in a paper and you'll understand, children. Some dictionary work also been given here. You can do it afterwards. First, you try to do this past and past perfect. I hope you all have understood the grammar properly. See you in the next session, children.